And so they did the same scene again, me with my mouth gaping open. When it came to the part where the girl messed up, she stayed silent and the boy said, "But what is puberty?" And Pubert answered, "Puberty is when your body goes through the changes that make you an adult." Pubister smiled, his lips gleaming. "That's right, Pubert, and we're here to help these kids understand their transition from children to adults." After a little bit of silence, Pubister ran over to the camera. "All right, cut. Was that so hard, Tabitha?" Emotionless, the girl shook her head. The boy stared at the floor. Pubister moved the camera to the side so Pubert took up the whole screen. "All right, honey. Sing the song. Just like we rehearsed it." After Pubister said action, Pubert started singing that horrible song. I fast-forwarded, still in shock from what I just saw. Pubert finished the song, and the shot changed back to the close-up of Pubister. This was strange, as the film seemed generally unedited, but there were still cuts here and there. Pubister appeared to be the director, and he didn't seem to be what my parents would call all there. Perhaps he forgot to edit the film before it was distributed. After Pubister finished his line, he said something without breaking eye contact with whatever was off camera. "All right, Betty, move the camera to the kids." The camera shifted to the boy and Tabitha squeakily, and the clown said, "Action." "Gee, that was a great song," the boy exclaimed. "Yeah, it was spectacular," Tabitha said in a monotone voice. Pubert started to say something, but Pubister stopped her. "No, Betty," he said, raising a gloved hand. His voice was strained, as if he struggled to keep his temper under control. "We're done for today. Tabitha needs some time out so she can reflect on her lack of acting." Tears welled in Tabitha's eyes. "No, Daddy. I'll do better next time." The shot changed to someone walking up the stairs. They had the camera in their hand, and I couldn't see who it was. They turned on the kitchen light, and walked over to the window. I could hear the rain pittering on the roof, and when the cameraman set the camera facing out the window, I saw how dark it was outside. They turned on the porch light, and outside I could see that the house was out in the middle of nowhere, surrounded by acres of cornfields. The front yard had a single baby tree and a dirt road stretching out for miles. But as the camera adjusted to the new light source and got less blurry, I noticed something attached to the tree. There was a flash of lightning, and for a split second, I saw it perfectly clear. Tabitha was chained by her legs to the tree, face first in the mud. Her back was heaving up and down, as if she were hyperventilating. The rain slapped the back of her neck, and her hands covered her head. Suddenly, someone started speaking. Their voice was crisp and crackly, they were probably speaking right next to the camera's microphone. "Consider this a lesson to bad actors, Tabby. Be more expressive or else you get to sleep out in the rain." The shot changed to a man in his kitchen, frying bacon. It was Pubister, only he wasn't wearing his makeup or suit. He was an average-looking guy, with some stubble and a bathrobe on. The sun shone through the kitchen window brightly, and the bacon sizzled and popped. Pubister was humming the puberty song that Pubert had sung the night before. The camera was probably set up in some cupboard, as I could see the whole kitchen. A woman with bedraggled hair and a white tank top stumbled in and turned on the coffee maker. "How did you sleep last night, honey?" Pubister asked, making Sunday morning small talk. It dawned on me that this woman, Betty, was Pubister's wife and was probably Pubert. Betty almost said something, but then her eyes were caught by something out the window. "Oh my God!" she screamed, running frantically out of the screen door. Pubister smiled to himself, flipping a few slices of bacon. About 30 seconds later, the screen door flung open, with Betty carrying Tabitha in her arms. The girl was soaking wet, and her face was a pale white color, as if she had been dressed up for her own funeral. Her eyes remained closed and her damp, matted hair hung from her scalp like wet noodles. Betty laid her down on the kitchen's tiled floor, putting her lips on her daughter's in an ignorant kind of attempt at CPR. This, however, was unneeded, as the girl's stomach was still heaving up and down just like it had been the night before, something Betty failed to notice. Tabitha was still alive. Pubister turned around and grinned at Betty, his hands clutching the counter behind him. "I let you say shit to my kids, Charlie, Betty gasped between pathetic necessitations, but this time, you've gone too fucking far. Charlie stayed silent, looking at his wife like she was an ant trying to escape a swimming pool.